DMSI channel. My name is Dr. Emenina Bright, and today I'll be talking about vaccines. All right, specifically, I'll be talking about the COVID-19 vaccine. We all know how we got to where we are. All right, so the conspiracies that greeted the emergence of the COVID-19 back then at the beginning, about a year ago, has not stopped. You hear about all the talk about it's not real, it is some person somewhere trying to create something to bring some government down, and so on and so forth. So from that, now we've moved on to another phase. We're in the phase now where as science had made it possible for vaccines to have been produced in such a short time. But the conspiracies aren't going away, obviously. Right now, there are several reasons why that people are putting up there, why the vaccines, why they should not take vaccines. I was on air the other day, specifically on AIT, and even my host didn't think I've convinced her enough to take the vaccines. So today we'll be looking at some of the reasons why that they give for not wanting to take the vaccines, why they think the vaccines are not either genuinely, or those who produce the vaccines have ulterior motives. By the way, you watching this video, I must tell you that vaccines have saved your life. If you are in this life, if you are on this earth, if you are an African child or an African individual or an African citizen, you cannot tell me anything different that vaccines have saved your life. So let me add that vaccines have been around for so long. Unfortunately, all right, this thing about vaccines, I ain't new, because I remember very well, my mom told me that back then, all right, while she was on queue to take vaccines, she had to leave the queue. She dodged. She was really trying to escape to say that I don't get to take the vaccines. You know why? Because she thought every child that came before her on the queue was crying after taking the vaccines, and she didn't just like the fact. All right. Thankfully, her husband had to return her the next day so that I take the vaccines. Probably that's why I'm here. Measles could have killed you, could have killed me. Polio have killed people, all right, and lots of other diseases. Even polio have killed people, have deformed people, all right. And so vaccines ain't new. We've had vaccines, and these conspiracies about them, I'm sure must have been there. But it's just that this time it's at a level that I'm sure we've never known before. So we'll just take a look at some of the reasons that people have given why they think that either the vaccines are not necessary, people should not either not take the vaccines, or why they think that these vaccines have been produced for some ulterior motive. We'll go through that. All right, so the first of them is that some persons have thought that the vaccines are created so that Africans, the black race, and especially Africans, can be wiped out. That the vaccines are some poison some persons in the world are about to use as weapons to like wipe out the whole of the black race. So we'll look at that. And then to make that justify that reasoning, they will usually talk about why malaria that's endemic in Africa is here to get a vaccine. So we'll take it like this. Yes, we know that malaria is here to get a vaccine. We do know also that there have been efforts to get vaccine for malaria. But we also know that, like the persons who usually argue, that the malaria itself is endemic. It's not a pandemic as is this coronavirus. So the resources are probably have been mobilized, and the urgency with which they think it should be addressed would usually be different. Understandably that. Alright, but let's take a step back and reason a little bit. All the anti-malaria and every other thing that comes into Africa for the treatment of malaria could have also been turned into poisons or be weaponized so that Africa can be wiped out. All right. And again, if you say that the persons here, that there is a plan, a grand plan to wipe out Africa or the black race by giving them vaccines, it would therefore be easier, all right, that those who had orchestrated this plan could have also come up with the talk about having a vaccine for malaria, pretentiously could have provided a vaccine for malaria with which to achieve this ulterior motive of theirs. So it doesn't really make any sense that you think that some person somewhere has orchestrated a plan to wipe out the black race. I don't know to what end that would be. I understand your fears. I understand the things that have happened in the past. I understand the syphilis program in the United States of America, where black males were deliberately abused as like as lab rats. All right, but come on, we ain't going to throw away the baby and the bathwater. We ain't going to continue to think about that and allow it to affect how we respond going forward. Okay, because for example, think about it. There was slavery, right? there was slavery now. Men from Africa were taken abroad to the West and were used as slaves many, many years ago. That hasn't stopped us from wanting to migrate, all right, to those places. So to think that because in the past something happened, and so in addition to being skeptical, you entirely are now preaching that vaccines should not be given, doesn't really make sense. We need to have a rethink about that. So I hope that that has been debunked. That if the purpose for these vaccines was to wipe out the black race, it would have been easier for anybody who wants that, who has that as a motive, to as well come up with a vaccine for malaria pretentiously. So that, because after all, it is Africa mostly, aside from some part of Asia that has malaria. So it would be easier for them to come up with a vaccine and say it's an anti-malaria vaccine, so that we all could just be wiped out. So we really need to ditch that. Now, the other thing that they've talked about, that people have talked about, and that this comes from the really big time conspiracy theories, those who thought at the beginning that coronavirus was not responsible for the death that we have been recorded, that the 5G was the problem, all right? Now, the talk is that these particular vaccines have been impregnated with certain chips that make the recognition or identification of individuals possible without any ID cards or passports. Come on, guys, think about it. Again, the last time that I was in the United States, I didn't need my passport to be checked in, to be passed to go through the airport, all right? So all I needed was my face, all right, and probably fingerprints with the machines, and I was recognized, all right, and allowed to go. So even if why is that even a problem? If it becomes necessary that people should carry chips so that they become easily identifiable, so that they become easily recognized, why would that be a problem? Are you sure that that's not already happening? I personally think that we're already there, because there are airports now have facilities that allows facial recognition, fingerprint alone. You don't necessarily have to bring an ID card or bring your passport before you are even allowed to go. So that won't be a reason why some persons they won't have to pretend under vaccination to want to achieve that. If the world thinks, if good reasoning had to prevail, and the world thinks that is the way to go with the kind of technology that we come across every day. So again, that doesn't hold water. I hope that also has been debunked. So the next thing is, so people have asked that, oh, in a bit to prove that it has ulterior motive, that the vaccines are produced because some people want to achieve something, all right? If you say that the pharmaceutical companies want to make profit, well, they will make profit, but I do not think that they have invented coronavirus because they want to make profit. That's the market, the school of thought that I don't buy. But they have now said that, okay, you are saying, people are saying we should get vaccinated, but how come after following vaccination, people could still have coronavirus? If following vaccination, people could still have the COVID-19 disease, so why then should we do the vaccination? So the question, or the answer to that question, is simple. Now, vaccines never really promise 100%. There are rarely any vaccines that you say promise 100%. But the good thing is, when people get vaccinated, even when they fall ill of this illness for which they've been vaccinated against, for the preventable illness that they've been vaccinated against, usually they don't have the severe illness. All right, so you could have measles after having been vaccinated for measles, all right, and still come down with measles. But the good thing is, the severity of the measles that you get when you get measles having been vaccinated is reduced. So yes, none of the vaccines so far so good has promised 100% prevention. And we are not saying that, oh, once you've been vaccinated, you should now become careless or reckless. You should not stop wearing your face mask and begin to mingle in crowds and do parties or go to places where you have no business going. We are not saying that because you wore a bulletproof vest, you should get careless and jump into bullets and so on and so forth. So it's the same thing. Yes, having been vaccinated, you still need to observe social distancing. We will still need to ensure that we wear face masks. We will still need to ensure that we prevent entering into crowd. All right, so that's the fact that we are saying still wear face masks, or yes, people could still come down with the infection even after they've been vaccinated, does not now mean that the vaccines should not be taken, or that those who do the vaccines have done it for some ulterior motive. So that's another reason that the people have given for saying why people should not get vaccinated. All right, so these are some of the things that we have always talked about. All right, the other thing that people have talked is why is it an mRNA vaccine? And the most unfortunate thing about this particular reason that they give is has also to do with the talk about it being some chip that allows people to be identified without ID cards or normal passport. All right. So what do you know about the mRNA vaccine, the mRNA in the first place, that make you think that an mRNA vaccine has to be some problem? Messenger RNA makes it a reason why you should not take it, why it is bad, why it's be purported to carry some things, all right, that it should not. So I will just throw a little light about the mRNA vaccine or messenger RNA vaccine. All right, so it is a messenger RNA because what it actually does is that it stimulates the body, it sends a message to the body, it sends just a message to the body that says that this is happening and therefore makes the body to prepare for a real attack of the virus. So you do not have any reasons to think that a messenger RNA vaccine is less effective or an RNA vaccine is better than a messenger RNA vaccine. We don't have any reasons to think that way. All right. So, ladies and gentlemen, like I said before, you are alive today. I'm alive today because we've had vaccines in the past, and this ain't going to change. COVID-19 had come. COVID-19 is a problem. The COVID vaccine had come. We hope that all parts of the world will get the vaccine in a short while, and we probably will be able to put COVID behind us. It's important that we do what we are doing, that this video goes out, because it appears that those who are anti-vaccination are doing far more work than those of us who most times are in the front line trying to battle the COVID and also trying to battle the misinformation that these people put out there. And so we have to probably double our effort in ensuring that we overcome these conspiracies. For that reason, I will admonish you that you share my video, get somebody to watch it with you, and see that this information goes out as we have said it. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask on the comment section. Thank you for watching, and I hope you watch our next video.